we're going to be looking at gastrointestinal secretion and its regulation. So specifically at this point in time, we're going to be focusing on saliva secretion followed by acid and pepsinogen secretion in the stomach. The following video will discuss secretion of pancreatic juice and bile and then rates of fluid movement. All right, so what regulates the synthesis and secretion of saliva? So first, we're just going to begin with a quick reminder about the glands that are associated with saliva production. So remember you learned earlier about the parotid glands. You learned about the sublingual and the submandibular gland. So remember these are responsible for the synthesis and secretion of saliva. So the taste and texture of the food is going to stimulate, and we'll just use a plus for stimulate. It's stimulating or it's detected by mechanoreceptors and taste receptors that are in the mouth. Once these receptors detect the taste and the texture of the food, that will send a message to the salivary center of the medulla. So the salivary center of the medulla is going to stimulate the autonomic nervous system, which then stimulates salivation. So if you're having a parasympathetic response, then your saliva is going to be watery. If you're having a sympathetic response, then your saliva is going to be real thick and it's going to be very mucousy. Okay, so think about this. Have you ever given a speech and during the speech you're nervous, right? You're having a sympathetic response. And so throughout the speech, you feel like you can't swallow because you just have this thick mucus that's in your mouth. And so you feel like if you do swallow that you might choke and maybe you'll choke on a mucus ball. Okay, that's because you're having a sympathetic response.